All the, say, banker to banker means policy framework, directives, swift and seamless clearing and other settlement services, efficient means of fund transfer from the banks to bank. So all these things, as I told you, SRR, CRR, repo, reverse repo, bank rate, these are the main thing where when the bank deals with RBI, either bank will give money or bank will take money from RBI, in that case it is called banker to the bank. So all bankers bank is RBI. Similarly, what are the powers of RBI? Powers is that first thing is that RBI gives license and cancels the license of the bank also. When bank is to be opened, RBI will be giving the license. Upon deciding whether they can run the bank or not, that way they will decide and give a license. And any bank who is not functioning well, that license can be cancelled by RBI only. Appointment and removal of the board of the banks. Each bank has got a board. CMD, ED and directors are there. So that board, appointment of that board is done by banks, as well as if somebody from the bank's chairman or something they have done wrong, that is removed means RBI will do. So removal and appointment of all the entire board of banks are done by RBI. Regulating the banking business, gives directions, inspection and supervision also. Certain times some inspections are carried out mandatorily by RBI. Under section 35 of RBI Act, RBI conducts inspection of all the banks. Audit of the banks. Inspection, RBI audit is done by RBI, this is called inspection, but audit is different. RBI appoints or gives direction to the bank that banks should be audited. So audit can be done by internal audit or can by external audit. External audit done by chartered accountant firms, everything. So external audit normally done once in a year. Internal audit may be done more than once in a year. So like this, audit of the banks are done. Collect collateral and furnish credit information. As I told you, RBI is the credit controlling authority of India. So RBI will collect the data from the banks, how much credit has been given, with what kind of credit is given. Collateral means collect and analyze those things, and finally furnish the credit information to the government of India. What is the stage of credit? Which sector has got what type of loan? Which sector is lagging behind? All these things are given by RBI. Every year it gives. Then banks moratorium, amalgamation, winding up or consolidation, if it's going to happen, this will be done by RBI. If some wrong things are made, then penalties are also imposed by RBI. RBI also acts as a banker to the government. As I told you, state government and central government, they maintain account with RBI. Whenever governments need fund, suppose state government need fund, it has to be through RBI only. So central government will sanction the fund, but money who will give? Government has money with RBI only, so RBI will give. Suppose, say Karnataka government. Karnataka government budget is, everything is going on. So tomorrow, say 2000 crore rupees is required by the Karnataka government, which is surplus than the existing budget. Budget, it was not there, but suddenly 2000 crore was needed for some project or something is there. So in that case, what will happen? This 2000 crore, how the government will take? Karnataka government, so for central sanctions, okay, 2000 crore you take. So normally what happens, every state and union territory, they maintain the account with RBI. So that is your overdraft account. And all state government, unitary government in India accounts are overdraft account which are running more than the limit. So overdraft means sanction limit will be there. So that limit is sanctioned. So our limit is say 2 lakh crore rupees. But they want 2000 crore more. So it will be 2 lakh 2000 crore. So that overdrawing is done through RBI. RBI gives money to all the state government, or central government requires that money is given. So that facility is called ways and means policy. 2-3 policies accounts are there where RBI gives more than the sanction limit money to the governments who require it. So even center if required, money, where from it will come? The money is not there. Suppose money is not, every budget money is decided, how much money is required, na? Budget. So budget is suppose done and budget is a exceeding budget. Money is not there. But your requirement is more. So what you will do? Suppose you want to purchase a, say, same thing. So if you want, then you have to take a loan only. Credit card is a loan only. Don't have money, you want to purchase. Tomorrow you will get salary and you will pay it. So for the time being, you are buying this from credit card only. So it is a overdraft account only, clean overdraft. So when you get salary, you have to pay it back. Similar thing here happens. This limit is created. Every day this balance is created. RBI gives only money, that's all. For what it will be, the RBI is not concerned, government is concerned. For what purpose they want? Central will give direction, 2000 crore can be withdrawn by Karnataka government tomorrow. So they can overdo. For what purpose it is going, that is done by the ministry and other people or bureaucratic. But RBI is only concerned about money. So in a budget, central budget, suppose, as I told you, excess budget is there. Suppose we have this much of money in circulation in India. Suppose 1000 rupees is the circulation. Now budget is 2000 rupees. So there is a deficit of 1000 rupees. So how the money will be coming? So there is a process called deficit financing. Means RBI has to print currency notes, 1000 rupees. When currency notes are produced excess, automatically it is required, you have to do it. But when currencies are produced more, inflation comes. So inflation cannot be contained unless this deficit financing, printing of notes is done. If printing of notes is, as I told you, that 200 crore, it is limited to that, then it's not a problem at all. No inflation will be there. But now what happened? Your gold bullion might be 200 crore, but you have issued 1000 crores of currency. So there is a gap of 800 crore. So this is the cause of inflation, all the price rise, everything. Because if money is more, your products and other things are less. So this is a very complicated area, very complicated. We are not going to that. So this is what the government to the banker to the government means, all the money which is required, RBI pays those money. Lack of money doesn't happen. Normally, a country which is more than 50 years old, lack of money will not be there. It is all the country have surplus money. See, we salary class, we know that we will get this salary. Okay, so if you want to overspend, you can say that I can postpone so many things. So in that, suppose you want to buy a car, but you don't want to take a loan. Suppose you are taking a loan, you are paying interest there also. So to adjust that, you have to curtail some other expenses also. Right? So this is like your home only. Entire country is run like that only. How you spend, if you overspend, then it will become a costly affair for you. Right? But if you do not overspend, then it will be a status affair for you. Because in your flat, you see everybody has got a car and you are running with a Activa.